Evening. Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Martha. Do you remember Martha? Martha, Martha, Martha. The one who was always beside herself. Now, sociologists tell us that the eldest brother or sister in the family kind of takes charge of the younger children. I don't know if that's true. I think that's true. It was true in our family, you know. It might be in your family also. They're kind of in control. And that's where Martha is coming from. But she's the eldest. You'll come to Mary and Lazarus. The three of them, she is the eldest. And so she is the one that always wants to be in control. In those days, a Jewish household was very hospitable. Nobody was ever turned away from the door that needed any kind of help, but they needed food, shelter, or whatever. Hospitality was there. And being the eldest, Martha took it upon herself not to be embarrassed by the lack of hospitality. She attended to detail, very much so that she missed the whole picture. You remember the story of Jesus coming? And she went into the kitchen and she was going to cooking this and cooking that. And her sister Mary was out there at the foot of Jesus, listening to Jesus. And she went out and complained to Jesus, "Look, Jesus, I'm out here working in the kitchen. It's hot, I'm tired, and Mary's not doing anything." And what does Jesus tell her? "Peace. Peace, Martha. Take it easy. Calm down. Calm down. What you're doing is all right, but you don't see the whole picture. You're not paying attention to the guest. And that's so very important. It's not only what you do, but the attention that you give to that you can't ignore the guest. You have to be hospitable to them in more ways than just attending to their wants or to their needs." And today, what happens in today's gospel? She chastises Jesus right off the bat as he's coming down the road, the dusty road. She runs out to greet him. "Where have you been? My brother's died 4 days ago. Where were you? He wouldn't have died if you didn't come. If you had been here, he wouldn't have died." And what does he do? He has to tell her, "Calm down. It's okay. I'm not only the Lord of this life, I'm the Lord of death too. I have power over death." And so he has to calm it down again. And not only that, he says, "Okay, we'll take care of the matter." But she says, "How can you do that? You know, Lazarus has been dead for 4 days. And already his body is decomposing." She is attending to the minute details. And again, missing the whole picture that nothing is impossible with Jesus, with our God. There's another episode in Scripture where Mary just serves. And she doesn't say a word. She just serves her guests. She finally learns her lesson to get a hold of the big picture. Detail is fine. Detail is fine. Paying attention to the finer aspects of anything is all well and good. But don't miss the big picture. Big picture. Be aware of what is happening outside of that. And she learned that lesson. Finally, after Jesus chastised her, came down on her, you know, a couple of times, you know, real nice and gentle, as Jesus always was, very gentle, and coming down on people, explaining to them, you know, this is not the way to do it. This is not the way to do it. But we can learn. Attentive to the real needs of people and pay attention to them. Pay attention to them. If they come to your home sometimes, what they need is not maybe a meal. They need to be fed by your listening to them. They need to be, they're there not so necessarily for physical comfort, but for emotional distress or whatever. And then all they want you to do is just sit there and listen. And sometimes if you're paying attention to detail, you miss that point. You miss the point of why they are there. So look at the big picture. Look at the big picture first. And then attend to the details. Martha wasn't there. Your heart was in the right place, as Jesus told her. It's not that she was doing bad, she was doing good. But don't miss the point of looking at the whole picture, seeing the big picture.